And welcome to the news at 7. My name is David Okwasile. The headlines this morning: state government calls on residents of riverine communities to relocate from devastating flood. Community children's homes in the state urged to uphold child adoption rules. Federal government allays fears on menace of flood. And on the foreign scene, United Arab Emirates supports UN proposal for peace talks on Yemen. Now, the news in detail. The state government has renewed its earlier directive to residents within the coastal areas of Obaru, Ayamelum, Anambra East and West local government areas to immediately evacuate their places in view of the raging flood threatening to overrun their areas. A release signed by the Commissioner for Information and Public Enlightenment, Mr. C. Don Adenoba, said that the forecast by relevant agencies that these places will experience very high levels of rainfall resulting in dangerous flood is coming to pass. According to Mr. Adenoba, the state government has made arrangements for effective and efficient evacuation of residents of these local government areas to relocate them to designated holding centers, which has been provided with sanitary facilities, water boreholes, beds, cooking utensils and foodstuffs. He said that a number of water ambulances and other marine transport vehicles are on standby. Commissioner Adenoba disclosed that all emergency services, including the Nigerian Navy, the Nigerian Army, the Nigerian Police Force and the Anambra State Fire Service, as well as the Anambra State Emergency Management Agency and National Emergency Management Agency, have been well mobilized. He advised residents of the affected areas to move immediately to avoid needless dangers in the face of imminent threat to life and property. The commissioner in the statement renewed the appeal of the state government to humanitarian and donor agencies, philanthropists and non-governmental organizations to assist in any way they deem fit to enable the people of Anambra State to grapple with the current severe challenges of flooding. Managers of community children homes in the state have been charged to abide with the rules and regulations stipulated by the Ministry of Social Welfare, Children and Women Affairs on child adoption or face the full weight of the law. The commissioner in charge of the ministry, Mrs. Ndidi Mezue, gave the charge when she inspected all registered community children homes across the state. Mrs. Mezue, who reminded managers of such homes that the adoption of children is free in Anambra State, stated that papers should only be given to those who pose necessary requirements for adoption. The commissioner urged them to create an enabling environment for the children so as to shield them from suffering psychological traumas as a result of that environment. She later made cash donations, various food items and toiletries to the homes. The Commissioner for Health, Dr. Josephat Akabike, says the state government will ensure that all those affected by the flooding in the state get the best of medical services. Dr. Akabike made this known when he led delegation officials of the Nigerian Center for Disease Control, Federal Ministry of Health, Abuja, to some holding centers in the state. Health correspondent Chibuzo Okoye was part of the entourage and filed this report.
Some of the holding centers visited were Umueri General Hospital, Father Joseph Memorial High School Agueri, both in Anambra East local government areas, and Obaru Local Government Secretariat Holding Center Atani. Briefing the ABS in Atani, Obaru Council area, on the essence of the tour, Dr. Akabike said that the exercise was to monitor and assess the operation of the medical personnel stationed at the sick base they established in all the holding centers in the state, to know the areas they recorded successes, as well as their challenges in order to enhance their services. The health commissioner, who pointed out that the sick base was set up to primarily take care of patients at the holding centers, noted that serious cases are referred to all the nearest general hospitals and revealed that they have had deliveries even with cesarean session in one of the holding centers.
Actually, sick bases. So we're going around to make sure that the people we set in, the nurses, the doctors and the doctors are helping us to make sure to see the challenges they have in terms of making sure they have enough doors and they're making sure that there is the seamless approach to working with.
According to Mr. Chimezie Anwe Yago of the Nigerian Center for Disease Control, their mandate is to prevent and control infectious diseases across the country, and said that they were in the state to educate and sensitize the people adversely affected by flooding on how best to stay away from infection as flooding increases the chance of infection through contaminated water.
We are here in the Center for Disease Control. It's part of a bigger team, a bigger health team here. We are working with NEMA, we are working with the Ministry of Environment. So we are here to assess the situation on the ground to make sure that things are in place, and we advise the state government, and if there are places we can come in to help, we also help.
The Transition Committee Chairman of Obare Local Government Area, Comrade Arinze Chukwu Awogu, described the magnitude of the flood in the area as outrageous and made it clear that the water level has been rising on a daily basis, which has kept sending more away from their homes. Comrade Awogu, who commended the State Emergency Management Agency, the Nigerian Emergency Management Agency, and other groups and organizations that are helping to alleviate the sufferings of the affected, said that the persons affected in Obare are in their need of all essential human needs, and commended the Minister of Health for their responsiveness.
The commissioner did the much he could to set up sickbay in all our holding centers, and each has not fewer than two nurses, right? With a doctor at an health center, where not less than 100 children have been taken to.
From Atani in Obare Local Government Area, it's been Chibuzo Okoye for ABS News.
As part of efforts to mitigate the effects of flood in some communities along the riverine areas, the State Coordination Office of the IFAD VCDP has notified the Nigerian Agricultural Insurance Corporation of the disaster. The situation, however, took the state head of the organization to Anambra East and West local government areas for proper documentation and evaluation. Correspondent Ebeleze has the report.
On arrival at Anambra West local government area, the team noticed that the entire area has been flooded while all the inhabitants have relocated to holding centers across the state. Speaking on the development, the state head of Agric Insurance, Nigerian Agricultural Insurance Corporation, Mr. Oseloko Zoma, described the havoc as a huge loss to farmers. Mr. Ozoma, who assured of the organization's intervention, lamented that nothing can be harvested from the farm.
The town has been vacated in view of the flood that came from Niger. You must be aware that this community share boundary with the River Niger, and currently all the farmers has left for IDP camps. If you look around, you can see the siege. It has taken, a story building has already, is already on the siege of water, half gone. And at the same time, the farmers, we can't even find any other farmers. We can't even have our way to the farm site now. With the record, you can easily see that this is a total loss to our farmers.
The IFAD VCDP Liaison Officer for Anambra West Local Government Area, Mr. Rufus Imoka, noted that the 2,328 VCDP rice and cassava farmers in the council area were insured.
The number of farmers under VCDP in Anambra West, all put together, both cassava and rice, is 2,328. This local government is predominantly agrarian area. It's all about agriculture. So the ones that are identified with the VCDP is 2,328 farmers. Initially, before they went back to farm, the VCDP management could be able to link all the VCDP farmers, both rice and cassava, to NAIC. That is the insurance, Nigerian insurance, people that is involved in insurance. So most of their farms were insured.
In their separate speeches, the chairman, Cassava Platform, Anambra West Local Government Area, Prince Paul Okolo, and the chairman, Anambra East VCDP Rice Farmers, Chief Udenze Ofodele, disclosed that about 40 hectares of cassava farm and 20 hectares of rice farm, almost due for harvest, have been submerged by the flood, appealing for assistance from all levels of government.
We encounter a lot of damages this year, and we are appealing to government to come to our aid, because we don't have any other hope.
You are in your government.
Narrating his ordeal, a seed rice entrepreneur who was trained by IFAD VCDP at International Institute for Tropical Agriculture, Ibadan, Oyo State, Mr. Chibuzo Obiechine, said his 2.5 hectares of seed rice farm, which the National Seed Council of Nigeria visited last 2 weeks during transplanting, has been covered by flood.
2 weeks ago, the National Seed Council video wali GPS nene ana ni ne oga avu nene kana me transplanting okay kitaz amu amaroz even amen na mila be obukulu ana ni ne ona enwe and ana wa the 2.5 hectares wa na and agasa sigi agasa mila be azia bukozi ali.
From Anambra East Local Government Area, I am Ebele Eze reporting for ABS News.
Igbo community, IMLM Council area, like other riverine communities of the state and beyond, is now counting losses as flood destroyed farmlands and submerged buildings and other facilities valued at millions of naira. Staff reporter Blessing Ijedibia, who was at Itulu farmland, observed that the flood resulted to premature harvest of crops and now reports.
A visit to Itulu farmland, where flood water submerged many hectares of land, destroying various farm produce, including yam, cassava, maize, and a species of beans known as akede, among others. Many of the affected people were seen in a boat crossing the Mambala River to a safe ground. One of them, Mrs. Udemma Ejike, said she decided to save her life and the lives of her children as the flood has continued to rise.
Okay.
The flooding has resulted to premature harvest, as premature yam and cassava tubers were spotted in various parts of the area, while Okada riders made brisk business as they convey flood victims to upland. Some of the farmers, including Chief Ibanugo Obiora and Adana Onyebo, said the flooding has inflicted heavy losses on them, as farming is their major source of livelihood, and call for assistance from the state government. On his part, the chief security officer of the town union, Mr. Ngosindo Abiam, said they now have a challenge of securing the flood victims from the most hit communities. In a similar development, flood has destroyed over 200 hectares of rice farm at Aomo in Ayamelun local government area. The destruction was occasioned by the major river in the area, the Opoto River, which overflew its bank. ABS News crew observed that some of the crops were in primary stages of growth, while others were almost at maturity stage before the menace. Some of the farmers, including Mr. Peter Anganti and Clement Udobiora, disclosed that most farmers took loans from banks, while others borrowed money from other sources. They call on the federal and state governments, as well as humanitarian agencies, to come to their aid.
Collected loan from bank through our cooperative society and through friends. I collected loan of 6,200,000. I included my own 2,100,000, making it 10,300,000. To cultivate 35 acres of land. All this fund, I used it to cultivate 35 acres of land on this particular land. As you can see, Ojabo, as you can see, these are the ones that have been already much older. They have already produced, rice is here already. Then you can see the green ones. All those green ones belongs to me. They were yet to produce, unfortunately, before this flood came into this place.
Okay. We are appealing to the state government, maybe through one of the agencies like SEMA, to come as a matter of urgent to our need.
In his reaction, the traditional law of the town, Igwe Chris Chidumbem, describes the flood menace as unfortunate. Also speaking, the president general of the town union, Chief Michael Nebife, said the community assisted the victims by providing boats to evacuate farm produce to safe ground.
We hope
for a bountiful rice harvest in Omo Ayamelin local government area of Anambra State may not be as expected. Blessing Ijedibia, ABS News.
And still to come, federal government allays fears of menace of flood. More stories after this short break.
Yes, Nigeria Independence Anniversary is here again. Coming Monday, 1st October 2018, Nigeria will be celebrating her 58th Independence Anniversary. Your darling station, Anambra Broadcasting Service, ABS, Heartbeat of the East, has created a special Independence Day package on ABS 88.5 FM and ABS TV Channel 24 to give the Anambra Ministries, departments and agencies, corporate organizations, civil society organizations, and other patriotic organizations the opportunity to celebrate and felicitate with His Excellency Chief Willie Obiano, Governor of Anambra State, the Anambra and fellow Nigerians. ABS 58 Independence Anniversary Package cost only 20,000 Naira. This package covers Independence Day message on TV, 3 slots. Independence Day message on radio, 3 slots. You may also pay for single Independence Day announcement on TV for 5,000 Naira or on radio for 3,000 Naira. Please contact KC on 080-33-888-526 to make your bookings. Let us celebrate Nigeria's 58th Independence Anniversary together.
Welcome back to the news. Still on flood, the federal government says the latest flood data has indicated that the worst is over as the water level at Lokoja and Lagdo Dam in Cameroon dropped significantly. The Minister of Water Resources, Alhaji Suleiman Adamu, made this known when he briefed State House correspondents on the outcome of the meeting of the Federal Executive Council on Wednesday. The meeting was presided over by Vice President Yemi Osinbajo at the Council Chamber of the Presidential Villa, Abuja. According to the minister, the water level at Lokoja has dropped by 6 centimeters, while that of Lagdo Dam has continued to go down. The Federal Executive Council has approved 612 million naira's revised estimated total cost for the completion of Cham Dam and development of 100 hectares of irrigation scheme in Balanga local government areas of Gombe State. The Minister of Water Resources, Alhaji Suleiman Adamu, again made this known when he briefed State House correspondents on the outcome of the meeting of the Federal Executive Council on Wednesday. The meeting was presided over by Vice President Yemi Osinbajo at the Council Chamber of the Presidential Villa, Abuja. Adamu said the project was initially awarded in 2011 at the cost of 832 million naira, saying the augmentation had now brought the total cost of the project to 1.44 billion naira. As part of activities lined up for the 2018 edition of the African Movie Academy Awards, the African Film Academy curators of Pan-African Awards will hold a training workshop for aspiring filmmakers in Kigali in partnership with the International Film School of Cuba from October. The awards will hold on the 20th at the Radisson Blue Hotel and Convention Center, and an African Cinema Business Roundtable will hold as a sideline event where focus will be on content distribution with the theme Unblocking Distributions, the Key to the Success of African Cinema. The African Film Academy has trained over 10,000 filmmakers across Africa and continues to do so with the support of Osigwe Anyamo Osigwe Foundation and other partners. Representatives from the film school will present certificates to the students that complete the workshop and will also take part in roundtable discussion, sharing their knowledge in how to train filmmakers within an industry that lacks infrastructure. The film school has attracted many renowned international filmmakers as visiting teachers for masterclasses and workshops. Moving on now to the foreign scene, an Emirati official says the United Arab Emirates will support UN proposals for a new peace talks on Yemen. The comments come just 2 weeks after the UN-sponsored peace talks collapsed before they could officially start, and a Saudi-UAE-led alliance advances on densely populated areas of the Houthi-held Hodeidah city. The failed talks, which would have been the first in nearly 2 years, were scheduled to take place in the Swiss city of Geneva on September 6, but the Houthi delegation failed to arrive, accusing the Saudi-UAE alliance fighting in Yemen of blocking them from traveling. Fighting has since intensified in the war-ravaged country, most significantly with a fresh offensive to retake the strategic western city of Hodeidah from the Houthis. The UN has spent the past few weeks scrambling to mediate between the warring sides, with Martin Griffiths, the UN Special Envoy for Yemen, holding separate face-to-face talks with the Yemeni government and Houthi rebels. We now move over to sports. President Muhammadu Buhari has congratulated Nigerian women basketball team, the Tigress, who recorded their second straight win at the ongoing FIBA Women's World Cup in Spain with a hard-fought 75-70 victory over Argentina. The president said the nation was proud of their performance so far in the competition. The keenly contested Nigeria-Argentina game played at the San Cristobal de la Laguna Tenerife saw the Nigerian side take the first quarter 19-13. The Argentines, who before the match against Nigeria were defeated in their first two games against Turkey and Australia, showed some intent in the second quarter with a 16-13 edge over the Tigress. However, in the final quarter, the Tigress kept their nerve to win 24-20. Remember that you can follow news and programs on ABS from any part of the world by logging on to our website, www.absradiotv.com, or you can follow, like us on Facebook, www.facebook.com/AnambraBroadcastingService, or on Twitter and Instagram at ABS Radio TV. Before we go, here are the headlines again. State government has sustained call on residents of riverland communities to relocate from devastating flood. Community children's homes in the state have been urged to uphold child adoption rules. Federal government has allayed fears on menace of flood. And from the foreign scene, we told you that the United Arab Emirates has expressed support for UN proposal for peace talks on Yemen to continue. On behalf of the editor, Zekopol, I am David Okwasile, thanking you for listening.